In this presentation, I will show you the short overview of AutoDXF. AutoDXF is an add-in for Autodesk Inventor. It's accessible from assembly environment and is used for batch creation and export of sheet metal flat patterns from entire assembly in a few steps. It allows you to easily collect all sheet metal components, create flat patterns, identify any issues with them, and batch export them to customizable DXF or DWG files. So let's see how it works. First step is finding all sheet metal components and also optionally automatically creating missing flat patterns. Those can also be created for mirrored components and parts generated using create components command that derives parts from multi-body master parts. So let's click the command. It goes through entire assembly, lists all the sheet metal parts, and also automatically creates missing flat patterns. You can see that some of the lines are yellow, which means that there are some bends in specific parts that are longer than maximum defined here in settings. In this way, you can quickly identify the sheet metal parts that cannot be bent on your specific machine that has 500 mm limit. The EFP status and EFPS no columns show the status and the presence of flat pattern. Let's see this case for example. In this case, the flat pattern is present and it was created manually before running the command. In this case, the flat pattern is also present and it was created automatically. There are also some other statuses, for example this one. This one says that the flat pattern was created, but that probably there's something wrong with it. So let's see what's wrong with the flat pattern. Right click on the row and click open part. I can see the flat pattern here, but if I turn it around, there is some extrusion here. So it's probably a mistake, and the program has some logic integrated that finds the sheet metal flat patterns that are probably not correct. This is one of the examples. So let's change this extrusion to cut, save this one. So now there is no problem with this specific one. The list of sheet metal parts also shows various properties of the components, such as quantity, material, mass, length and width of flat patterns, part number, stock number and thickness. Beside that, you also get the images, the previews of the components. The model preview shows the 3D model, and the flat pattern preview can show the preview of flat pattern. Those have to be generated. You can generate them manually for specific component or automatically for all the components. So the result are the thumbnails of flat patterns. In this way, you have easy access to all the flat patterns, and if it's necessary, you can also rotate them. Let's say I want to rotate this one for 90 degrees. I will right click on the row and select rotate flat pattern for 90 degrees. As you can see, it was rotated. Next step is defining the DXF or DWG settings in the settings tab. You can set the file locations, geometry post-processing options, file naming, and also you can include text descriptions in DXF files. All the settings are automatically saved for next use, so you don't have to go through all the settings each time you run out of DXF. Let's change file naming. We can set that part num. And let's say that you want to have thickness in file name. Thickness, and that's a divider between the those properties. Let's say you want minus. Also, we will add some DXF text descriptions. They will be put on layer named AutoDXF text, which will be in yellow color. Also, the layer names, the layer presence, layer color, line time, and line width can be set. You can rename the layers. This one is bent. Let's say this one is outer profile and inner profile. this one should be, let's say, in this color. After the settings are done, you go to the next step, which is exporting the files. The files can be exported to DXF or DWG, both in version 2000. So let's click export button. We have 40 flat patterns selected and they are being exported. Exporting is finished, so let's open a few examples in AutoCAD. Those are the files that were just exported. Let's open a few examples. And this is the geometry we get in DXF. You can see that the layer names and colors and also line types were set in Inventor and are also visible here. And you also get text description on a separate layer. So if someone opens this DXF, he can immediately see the properties of the sheet metal component. AutoDXF can also export the list of sheet metal components to Clipboard or to Microsoft Word. Let's click the command to export the list to Microsoft Word. After the exporting is done, you can switch to Microsoft Word and you can see that you get a table with all the sheet metal components from your assembly listed. You can simply print this out and include as additional documentation when manufacturing the sheet metal parts. That was a quick overview of AutoDXF. For more information, please visit www.basic.si/autodxf, and you can also download the demo version from that website. Thank you for your attention.